Now, first of all, I wanted to make a video to just answer some of the questions that I got recently, and it's very hard to just type answers. I know there are some really good tutorials out there and experts that are much more in-depth and have in-depth knowledge. I got some questions. Somebody asked me about how do you import or export or gravity sketch. Gravity sketch is a different beast. I have some gravity sketch, not even tutorials, more process explorations on the YouTube. I'm not making tutorials, but what I can do is at least show the flow of the creation of the pavilion. And first I'll go in a little bit into the mood boarding, so you can skip that part if you want to go straight to the blender, which is the second part. And then the third part, I'll just explain a little bit about the Unity setup and about the use of prefabs, the bakery, reflection probes, and some other topics, and mostly optimization. I think prefabs and optimization and understanding baked light, which I'm still not an expert on, is kind of at least touched upon in relation to the pavilion build. Okay, let's continue. Make sure we have... All right, so basically, let's talk through the scene a little bit. I'm in baked light matte mode. I can also go to shaded wireframe or shaded. So basically then the importing of all the pieces that you have loaded in here. I talked a little bit about prefab. I talked about the models, so let's say, well, I haven't talked about the models, import as FBX, and then baking it as a bakery, and you do that with bakery light maps. So I have here a list of bakery light maps. Not all of them are actually on anymore. But those are the lights that actually provide with you. So let's say I select all of them and just pull them out a little bit. These are not all active, are the bakery lights that create the lighting for this space. And as you can see, I use, for instance, this trick of having these long strips underneath the pavilion that create those light strips. So you have to kind of play with that a little bit and see how you go with those lights. So each area needs to have a specific bakery light map. And here you see next to Mona, there's a bakery menu. You said create area light, bakery light, the directional light. And then also we have a bunch of reflection dome probes. So make sure you set up a reflection probe. So if I have gizmos on, and I make the gizmos a little bigger. So here you can select the size of your icons. I don't see them at the moment. Okay. And now I, why are my icons not on? 3D icons. Okay, so it's apparently I didn't have enough practice recently. My icons are not on. So these, let's go to a specific reflection drone, dome or probe, and see what it does. So the reflection probe in this room, for instance, is here. And you have to set them up per space. And what it will do is it'll actually map that reflection for that area, again, using bakery. So after you find a good way to render and to bake your space with the good texels per unit, bounces and samples, keep it low, start low first, otherwise it becomes way too heavy, low resolution, optimization, right? Don't go nuts, optimization is everything. Then you hit your render reflection probes, and that will kind of render those, and suddenly your space will come alive with more light. And everything that needs to be reflecting will be bringing light to the spaces. And I think I took the liberty of not worrying too much about artifacts like this and about like pixelization like this. I mostly focused on optimization of the space. So you get that beautiful light like I showed you earlier. You see these strips of light here, for instance, create that light effect on the base of that underside of that surface. So that's about baking and bakery. It can be done with the standard tools as well. So I'm not an expert on that at all. These are a couple of artifacts that I actually have imported from Artvis Pro. I sent those guys a note saying, hey, we will remove them soon because according to their license, we're not allowed to sell these onwards. But you can also drop them in, put them on to being a static. They were a static for baking and bake them. Then some people ask me about gravity sketch, so we can do a special session or some of the other YouTubes on my channel show you about building low poly goods. Again, you can see really low poly, not much to it. There's a lot more you can do, but I also see a lot of people going sketching, you know, wonderful pieces of art, and then you drop them in Unity and it chokes the system. So I would kind of recommend to make sure you keep everything light. It's more like pointillism. We do a little bit with a lot so that people can at least walk through it and flow through it. Now somebody asked me, I think Vartist, nice to meet you, Vartist. So your request spurred for me the making of this video. And you talked about the canvases, right? So I think these are fairly simple boards that I use. And as you can see, they're set to static, which is actually a bit of an issue, because if we now sell this piece and I remove it from the wall, as you can see, you're going to get this baked pavilion that looks quite horrible. I still decided to have that little shadow. I think it's just so much nicer, these light effects. I love the sunlight in the morning to the trees. And basically what these are just very simple boxes. And then on the material, I keep creating new materials. So this is just history of Bart's, history of the world with Bart's art. So I go to history. You do a lot with search, right? You have this as a material. And then I'll just make the history of Bart's is a material. Is it a material? I don't know, man. Oh, that's a sprite, sorry. It's a sprite and it should be a material. So if you want to duplicate a new poster, you duplicate the material. Then you pick another sprite in your slot. That's there. And then you say, take this copy, drop it on there. It's a bit of a crude way of doing things, to be honest, but that's me. And sometimes you find a piece of art of sorts. Is it actually a sprite or not that's processed? Can I actually drop this sprite on there? I'm not quite sure. Yes, so here you can see it's set to sprite. So each texture needs to be set to sprite or something like that. And then you need to hit apply at the resolution that you want, 1024, for example. And then I can drop it not on there, but on the material. So the copy of that material is this. And then in that slot, I can throw this there. And then you see it's a poster. Sometimes, I mean, this is a very crude way of doing it. Obviously, it has to be X, Y correct and things like that. But that's literally how I, whoops, I just deleted everything. Be careful not to delete everything because this is an artifact. And I'm changing things within a prefab. Again, if you do that, be very careful because it can screw up other prefabs. If I just wanted to delete this, I can. But make sure what happened to the overall prefab now, because look at the prefab, it's all of the posters. Undo. Go to, currently there is no overwrite. So in the top right corner, you'll see if there are overwrites or not. So when you're doing prefabs, be very careful that what you're doing there. So that was the question on the poster. So in general, build extremely cleanly. Build extremely lightweight, optimize, and test. I see people doing it as well, the testing every day. This kind of canopy is done in Gravity Sketch. It's kind of like a fun project to tie some knots. We come in from the other side, to tie some knots in Gravity Sketch and see how heavy that is. So it's not an optimized surface, it's just dropped in. The little robot over there is also, let me zoom in on that one, a very rough little gravity sketch model, probably not even detailed at all. And then I used the trick with the line. So there's actually a line tool. So if you go to this guy, there's a line tool in Secret of the Sauce that I discovered during making of Redwater 1, the game. There is an there's a line that you can actually use, line render. Don't even know if it's a. I don't even know if it's a. How I did it. If it's a particle effect or not. But look up line render, and then I just animated it using an animator, and then you get this effect of the semi-random with the motion of the bot. You get this semi-rending random scanning. And there you see it's an audio source. It has the museum closing. It has the spatial blend. So there's a spatial blend you kind of have to figure out on the audio component. Why again am I not seeing the gizmos? Yeah, here you go. So then the gizmos, this is what I mean with the gizmos. You switch that on. And now you can actually, with the circle, you can hardly see it, drag the moment where you can hear it. So when the robot, when you're within robot's earshot, you can now start hearing it. So that's not Doppler, that's stereo, spatial blend, I believe, has to be on 3D. Yeah. Quick tip on that one. I'm in a prefab, so I got to get out again on the robot, make sure nothing's damaged on that prefab, and check if there are no overrides. So now the gizmos are super large. Let's turn them off again. So other questions I got was on the LiDAR. Let's quickly see where the LiDAR is. And I mean, to be honest, I'm doing a lot of failing to just figure stuff out too, right? And a lot of testing. So here, this was an idea to do minimum LiDAR. I had to kind of keep it minimal, keep it below a certain amount of artifact, of polys, and then use the decimate in Blender. I did the little boat here in Gravity Sketch. So that was kind of a quick rebuild of my uncle's antiques. All these antiques hopefully will be minted as well on OpenSea, that so that people can go into the gallery, purchase an item, and then we ship them maybe the real antique object. I mean, it's the history of the future, right? But let's talk a little bit about the building techniques. There's another LiDAR over there. That's the bigger one. That's the antique, not for sale. It's not for sale. I can't sell my uncle's gallery. But he's kind of there building his boats, but it just gives a lot of warmth. And mostly I just wanted to see if I can get it in there. Up here, I just left the bakery light hanging. I thought it'd give it this nice glow. For the rest, there's no chamfers on the concrete. Oh yeah, colliders, right? So you have to create these collider objects, collider jump. So each of these are all turned off, perhaps. They don't even have a render. Where are the colliders? So each of these collider, usually I actually created separate. No, I think, sorry, correction. This has a mesh collider, which is heavy and expensive. So the mesh collider is very expensive. The main building has a mesh collider, which is kind of expensive. So I did use colliders. I remember I also used these kind of jump collider jump planes. Let me just bring one up and go to it. Oh yeah. So here, for instance, for that bridge, I used a little walk plane that is just not rendered, but it is there, that has a box collider. I'm trying to hurry up, mostly for my hard disk, because my hard disk is probably not capable of doing so many things. Then there's these animated little planes that go back and forth, and the wood lift. I'll show you something else on the wood lift. It needed these, that was a tip from Justin, I think. It needed these two things to make sure you don't slide off. So they're invisible, but they do have a box collider on them. And if you're lucky, you get dragged to the other side of the void. Okay, now that's a lot. Up here, I did not really focus on detail at all. Maybe it's nice to just do a full blown. Let me turn the animation off real quick. Let's do a full blown tour of the space, right? It's kind of a majestic. So yeah, as you can see, fairly simple, straightforward. Lighting is mostly bakery. I just love how it looks with the sunlight, I think that's a big part of the atmosphere. The 5 o'clock in the morning or 7 in the morning in Italy, you know, you'll never forget. Some sketches and stuff of mine that I own there, that I had in here. Now, mind you, if you do the reflection probe properly, rendering the reflection probe might bring suddenly the light back. So here, this one's not baked. As you can see, it's probably done a little later because I wanted it to be removable as a minted artifact. Therefore, the sun's not hitting it, and it really, really is not optimal. I think it's because I've moved something or moved them around. Currently, these are not baked, as you can see, but I chose to bake everything. Even at that stage, I didn't even know if I could remove the art or not later. This is an old sketch of my apple fan that I had. So yeah, here's another. I just threw some art on there just as placeholders, but these are some of my concept drawings and things like that. The pavilion is done with light emitters. Now let me see if they were from how I did them exactly. Oh yeah, so the glow posts have just simply a glow material on them. So the glow posts have a fairly bright material on them and are glowing. I did have a reflected pane into the doorway earlier. I don't see it switched on here. I probably switched it off. Oh, there's a model missing here. I had that little car in here, right? I don't understand why that model is missing. It's been a while that I've been in here, and now we're preparing for the next round. It's going to be interesting. Whether we do a love to do a starship build, but of course you have to get that right. I had plenty of ideas of a pavilion number 2. I think starship is a brilliant idea. As you can see, I have quite some blender kind of like space posters here. Oh yeah, the little display signs. We find one here. Are part of the artifacts, and where is that part? Oh, here, portals. No, oh, I've got everything selected, no wonder. What I wanted to show you as a last item maybe is the display sign. There it is, display board. So let's go to display board. Displays all is a, I know what's happening, this needs to be docked. Now I can go into displays all, and apparently, let's select the one that is where I'm looking at, go through it with a arrows. There it is. I now open it, and I can show you how I did that. So it is a stand, which is the very simple, basic kind of foot. And then it has a display, and that has an image map on it, as you can see here behind my Trony. And then it just has a source image mapped on it with a transparency. So you can drag the transparency there. And it wasn't a graphic marvel, but it was also not a canvas. So it was a cheap way to do it. You can do user interface canvases. And I could literally go in for each of these and type in the text here, which was a bit painful. So there was no real structure there. Probably I would do it differently, maybe as a floating canvas the other day. But this was a sprint. Remember, this was a sprint to get everything done on time and rapidly. For the pool, the Mobius pool, you've now seen the secret of where I got it. It's a classic trick, right? Pool of lava, the pool of light. So there's also this kind of heritage of a Roman kind of atrium, right? There's some classic architecture rules in there that give you the feeling of recognition. So for instance, an atrium with a pool in the middle is probably the coolest house you can ever have. There's also an elevator going down into it, as you know, may have noticed, and that is just a massive glowing plane, and then there's a little sound source in there that gives off a little bit of the whale noise to sort of try to create the experience, just like the piano next to the other piece. So with that, I close this video, and I'll go into more detailed questions if you have them. This is not a tutorial, this is just a quick build overview from beginning to end, and the 2 weeks maybe a week and a half for just optimizing, communicating a lot with Justin, and thank you Matt and Justin, everybody, for the last 2 days to get the artifact stuff going. We still need to swap them out, but optimizing and testing continuously, dropping it into, going to the Mono Playground, build playground files, dropping it into Chrome. I think I must have done that 1,000 times because I wanted to make sure people had a nice walkthrough experience. So that is, for me, my palace, my pavilion. It is about heritage, my grandfather's pavilion of the World's Fair, and it's about the first step in the metaverse. So there will be a lot more. I think there's thousands of ideas, but I love how it came out for the first experiment. By the way, these are some Blender tissue experiments I did in Blender with tissue that we can go into in another topic. It's Mr. Zomparelli created this tissue add-on that you can create self-generative stuff, and it's really fantastic. So those are some architectural sketches, fairly quick, half an hour, and then rendered, not even rendered, it's just screenshots. This was an old electric motorbike long before Tesla, that I did with the fold without solar panels. Why would that not be the coolest thing on earth, right? Have the satellite falling out when you park. It's the cafe racer where you fold it out. So I got to do a new version of that. I'm a lot about those type of quick concepts. And then I have trouble to go back again and refine it because it's the time needed is too much for some of those projects. Okay, thanks very much. And if you have more questions, let me know on Discord or anything like that. And getting ready to get a good idea for the next build. Maybe it is a Martian landscape or a Martian or a starship kind of build. I'm really intrigued with that. Or the Monsters, Inc. Portal, so that we can have all the portals go to the different spaces. It's a hangout with street art where we can be hanging out in the middle and then disappearing into the different pavilions. Okay. Ciao, ciao, everybody. And yeah, it's great to be part of the new, I would call it, revolution in art. It's like Dadaism or Pointillism, or, you know, voxel edit is Pointillism. I think we're really here in not only impressionism but realism. I mean, this is a big art movement that's happening right now. That's the way I see it. It's a big art movement. So yeah, we're part of a big art movement. Okay, ciao ciao. What can you actually do with those pieces of art? How do you actually bring them in? Optimization, decimation. We'll talk a little bit about that too. So with that, I hope you liked the video. I hope you could ignore the bar below with the translation going on, but sometimes you just have to take what you have and tick it off and go to the next item, and maybe later you can revisit it. Perfection is also the killer of process, so you got to make pilots, you got to make mistakes, and then build the next one better. So it's really about accepting a certain level of quality whilst you go for world-class quality, and it might not be the first time that you hit it. So slowly build it up, keep your sanity, go to your sports, go outside, and keep to the scrum, keep to a scrum rhythm, and then you can do an insane amount of stuff and you will surprise yourself. And that really helped me stay sane in this process because it was a pretty intense sprint, and again, a lot of optimization. So first part, concepts, a little bit of sketching, then we go into Blender, skip any part if you want, and then the third part will be Unity, touching upon some thoughts. It's not a tutorial. Okay, hope you like the video.